Hello friends, this is Bhaskar, senior researcher from Janta Ka Mood Political Research and Consultancy. Today we are going to discuss with you the different aspects of previous election analysis, voting pattern analysis, and based on that you can see that how this collated analysis of different years help you understand the current situation of each party at different booths in different areas. So let me show you. Like, this is for UP, Jhansi is the district, and the parliamentary constituency is again Jhansi, and the assembly is Babina, 222 for Uttar Pradesh. This is now the about the recently held elections in Uttar Pradesh. So just to give you an idea, so this Babina constituency is divided into these different areas, which are the blocks or urban areas as well as rural areas. So like there are Barua Sagar Nagar, Badgaon Nagar, Badgaon block, Babina block. So it has both like Dehat Panchayats and blocks and Nagar areas, and we can see that the voting pattern in different areas is different. I will just explain you how. First, before that, I want to give you a glimpse of that in different blocks there are different number of booths that are present. So like Babina block, as we see here, has 142 booths. So it is the largest block of this Babina constituency. Similarly, Badgaon block has 89 booths, Badgaon Nagar has 7, Begusarai Nagar has 15, and so on and so forth. Altogether there are 349 booths. Now here we have done polling booth wise party strength analysis. So as you can see here, this is a combined analysis of year 2014 election, 2012 election. So these two elections, the recently held two consecutive election analysis was done for Babina with respect to the current 2017 election. Now if I select, so right now as you see that there are all together, let me show you, 355 booths are there. Actually it's not 355 minus these 6 is 349 booths. And area wise if you see, so let me just choose Jhansi Nagar, let's say. Jhansi Nagar is the urban area here. So if I choose Jhansi Nagar, now I see that all together these are 26 booths in Jhansi Nagar. So these 26 booths are the urban booths, and in urban booths 26 minus again 6, which is 20 booths. These are the names of the booth: Rani Jhansi Bai, Rani Lakshmi Bai Junior High School Bhag Do. So you see there are total 584 voters here, which were in 2017. In 2014 there were 588 voters here, out of which the voting polled was 301, which is 51% votes were polled, and BJP got 22 votes. BSP got 22 votes. This was parliamentary election. BJP got 150 votes, SP 51, and Congress got 72 votes. So as you see this color pattern, from light yellow to dark red describes the ranking of different party in terms of the number of votes secured by them on this booth in descending order. And here this is, as you see, SP and Congress combined, they have got 123 votes. So this is a derived analysis that we have done, because in 17 elections in UP, Congress and Samajwadi Party were contesting together. Now in 2012, this same booth, Rani Lakshmi Bai Junior Secondary School High School, this booth number was 309. There were 548 voters. Voting percentage was 54, and these were the So you can see, so here mostly every one of them got similar number of votes. That's why the color variation isn't too much. Now, if I show you the BSP number of total number of votes as I have added here, so it's 871 votes in these 20 booths. So BSP was weak in these urban booths. Now, if I see BJP, so actually BJP sweeped this area. So BJP has 6,187 votes. SP has 1,200 votes. And Congress has again 1,700, close to 1,700 votes. So this is just a glimpse of previous election voting pattern that I wanted to show you. Now, when we do this, this is a like area wise analysis. So now, when we do this analysis on different areas within the constituency, be it assembly constituency or parliamentary assembly constituency, it gives us a good idea of our strengths and weaknesses, our strongholds, our weak holds, the moderate ones, and there we can accordingly strategize in the upcoming election where we are contesting in terms of where should we focus our resources, how much. So it significantly reduces our expenditure later on in terms of election expenditure, and at the same time enhances our returns in terms of votes. So overall ROI is positive if we use scientific methods. Thank you.